Make sure you guys smash that subscribe button if you guys are fans of the content being posted onto this channel to always be in the loop with more content similar to this, and be sure to hit the video up with a like if you're enjoying the content, and with that being said, let's begin. With Capcom's Resident Evil 8 Village now having to be officially confirmed, set to be released in 2021, the entire fandom within the Resident Evil community are seemingly jumping for joy in the idea that Capcom had finally listened to its fans in giving us the product of what made survival horror special within Resident Evil, and given the fact that Resident Evil 8 Village is supposed to introduce a very different narrative by comparison to the previous Resident Evil titles before it, outside of course having enemies that resemble Ganados, zombies, and beastmen, we've also got major hints within Resident Evil Village that in fact we are going to see vampires be included in the game as well. Now, although this may seem like a stretch, when having to take a look at the leaked inventory provided by Capcom, the currency within the briefcase seems to resemble that of Romanian currency, which further goes on to imply on the idea that this game will be set in Romania, specifically Transylvania, Romania, which that in and of itself is seemingly the perfect location for a game like this, and based on its overall folklore, in Transylvania it was also said many generations ago that vampires existed, so it's only fitting for Ethan Winters to travel to Transylvania, Romania, and encounter this cult that seems to be worshipping the new virus. But on top of that, the indication for us to get actual vampires in the game comes from the group of individual females shown in the trailer itself, and as you guys can see on screen when first having to observe these characters, there's really nothing major that comes from these characters that makes someone kind of wonder as to who they were or what their purpose may be, until you begin to zoom in on their faces a bit and begin to notice something very unusual that actually resembles that of a blood-sucking vampire. And a good example of this is, as of course you guys can see on screen, each and every single one of these individuals, minus the woman in the middle, actually has blood around their mouth. They have blood dripping down from their chin, and this really is an indication that in fact they're not zombies, they're not beast women, they're not Ganados-like enemies, but instead, they seem to come off very vampiric in nature, and one may actually point out and say that it's simply makeup or their lipstick had been smudged, but in fact it's not, because their lipstick seems to be intact right where it is, versus the blood-like textures all around their face, which goes as far as to indicate that these women that we're going to be dealing with within the castle are in fact vampires. Now, towards the end of the trailer, as you guys can see, the main boss-like woman is actually shown sucking on Ethan's wrist, and if you pay close enough attention, you could see the difference between the lipstick that she has on and the blood that's around her lips, because this goes as far as to tell me that at some point within Resident Evil Village, once you end up venturing in the castle, you are going to come across these vampiric-like creatures, and it only makes sense because the story of Dracula originally came from Transylvania, of course, eerily enough, having to do with a queen-like figure that was feasting and sucking on the blood of the villagers and the people around her town, specifically other women in this case. And I love the fact that Capcom is actually including this kind of a concept within Resident Evil Village, only because when you're on the outside of the castle, you're going to be dealing with zombies, you're going to be dealing with beastmen, executioners, you're going to be dealing with Ganados-like enemies, you're going to be dealing with the witch, and when you're inside the castle, apparently enough, you are going to be dealing with vampiric-like creatures, of course, resembling that of women. Which really goes as far as to show how much Capcom had invested in this, especially if we're going to be battling several different kinds of enemies that are all going to be different in nature. The beastmen that could possibly even evolve, we have zombies, which we don't know what kind of zombies they are, if they're going to be similar to Crimson Heads to where they can run, or slow-moving zombies, perhaps maybe Ganados-like enemies that resemble that of those seen in Resident Evil 4. Within the current village right now, we have the possible introduction of the executioner, possible vampires, and many other inclusions, and we're only beginning to scratch the surface because I'm fairly certain that Capcom has so much more planned for us, which actually really raises the bar by comparison to Resident Evil 7. We really aren't going to be seeing anything come from the mold or anything involving something similar to the Baker family, and with rumors of Alex Wesker having to be the main enemy of the game along with Alan R, which we don't know who Alan R. particularly is, but what's also most interesting is the fact that the cult seems to be after the child, and my guess for this was, as we discussed on the previous video, was because this cult is looking to capture and obtain the child of Ethan and Mia as a means of using that child in a sacrifice for said reasons. Now, this cult doesn't seem like they want to take over the world. This cult doesn't really seem like they're out to destroy the entire population of the world, but instead, they're actually very vindictive, they're very well organized, and they're very well placed in a sense to where they seem to be acting as one versus an individual unit. And as you guys can see on screen, this particular image, this symbol, is going to be very important within the game, and if you pay close enough attention, it looks like there's a baby or a fetus in the middle, which really goes as far as to raise a bunch of eyebrows as to what this could mean. And we've seen this symbol actually all around the trailer, on the floor, on the wall, so I'm fairly certain that this is the cult's kind of representative symbol. But at the same time, there's a greater meaning behind this, especially if there is a fetus or a baby in the middle that seems to be mutating, or there seems to be something growing out of it, which is very abnormal, which again kind of harpens back to the cult wanting to use the child of Mia and Ethan as a means of a sacrifice. So at the same time, Capcom is promising to give us a lot more by the end of the summer, which only means that we might get a trailer number two, that we might actually get potential gameplay, because there is so much more involving this game, as we don't really know when the actual release date of this game is going to be, only other than the fact that it's going to come out in 2021 by the end of the summer, which is roughly around August or September. Expect to see another trailer, expect to see possibly additional gameplay of the village itself, as remember, based on the overall rumors and original leaks, that when you start the game off as Ethan, you're not going to have anything other than a flashlight. So I'm only guessing that you are going to encounter the Beastmen, the Executioner, and all of the zombies and Ganados as you try to escape the village and make your way deeper into the forest and caves, which we already know are confirmed to be in the game. And it is going to be a place where Ethan is going to be traveling into and trying to mainly focus on surviving. But the most interesting part of this entire video is the fact that we are going to potentially be getting vampires. And this is something very different, because we really haven't seen all of these kinds of elements included in a Resident Evil game at the same time. I mean, granted, we've seen concepts and ideas stem from Resident Evil 4 to Resident Evil 5, Resident Evil Outbreak, Resident Evil 0, Resident Evil 1, and each and every single game included different elements, different enemies. But here, we're not only going to be getting different elements and different enemies, but more or less different kinds of enemies, a variety of enemies be included in one single game, and that really hasn't been done since the OG classics way back in the day. So by the end of all of this, I want to get your thoughts in the comment section below about the possibility of vampires, about the possibility of there having to be a cult seeking the child of Ethan and Mia to use as a means of a sacrifice. And by the end of all of this, do you guys believe that Resident Evil 8 potentially could end up being one of the greatest Resident Evil games within the franchise, only because of the main focus that Capcom has in giving us a survival horror-esque game? And they are going to be upping it up with the action as well, but the game is still solely grounded on survival horror and survival horror only. So are you guys excited? Are you guys concerned? I want to get your thoughts and feedback down below. Again, thank you all so much for watching. Thank you all so much for your time. If of course you guys are new, then be sure to go on ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on all notifications to never miss a single video on the channel. If of course you guys are excited and are going to be getting Resident Evil 8, then I do also encourage you guys to smash that like button down below by giving this video a big thumbs up. There is so much more coming from the game that I really can't wait, and this game actually feels like a hybrid between Resident Evil 4 and Resident Evil 7. It's kind of weird, but at the same time, I really genuinely feel as if Capcom actually heard our pleads and our cries for getting a good, a suitable enough game that isn't as boring as Resident Evil 7, but isn't as action-oriented as Resident Evil 6. So they've kind of blended in a little bit of Resident Evil 2, Resident Evil 4, Resident Evil 3, Resident Evil Remakes, Resident Evil 7, all into one, and I cannot wait to see what's going to happen. So again, we have a lot to look forward to, and I really cannot wait because again, we're going to be getting more towards the end of the summer, so keep your eyes and ears peeled out for that. So thank you all so much for watching, thank you all so much for your time, tune back in for the next video, and I'll be seeing each and every single one of you guys down in the comment section below. Have a great day, everybody. Peace.